Today, I'm super excited to show you how you can create a dynamic text animation in Adobe After Effects. You can use these motion graphics to create animated titles for things like short films, web series and more to introduce the name of the artist in a highly creative way. But before we start, if you are watching my video for the very first time, please do consider subscribing and like this video if you enjoy this tutorial, and also do comment if you have any question or thoughts. Hey everyone, it's Vikash from Skyline Motions, and no more waiting, let's jump right into After Effects and get started. Let's go. Alright, so this is Adobe After Effects, and let's start by creating a new composition. Click on this new composition button, or you can just go over here and take a new composition, and this is gonna be our main composition. You can also call it render comp. Set the size of this composition 1920 in width, 1080 in height, which is the 1920 by 1080 full HD resolution. But if you want to create this animation in 4K, select the 4K preset from here. Now we have to select a frame rate, so in this case I'm using 60 frames per second for a smooth animation. Duration make it 5 seconds long, which is good enough for one title animation. Background color black, hit OK. After that we have to import a texture file for this animation, so just go to the project window, right click on that, go to import file and select a texture file. So in this case I'm using this wall texture. You can use any wall texture or paper texture, whatever you like. You can download the complete project file, I will give you a link in the description. So once you have downloaded the texture file, select the texture file, click on import. And now we have to create a separate composition for this texture file. So just go to composition, take a new composition, and this is gonna be the texture. Leave the setting as it is, you don't have to change anything, hit OK. And now let's import this texture file inside of the texture. Hit S to bring out the scale property. Let's scale it down a bit, and as you can see we have a vertical portrait image. So hold shift on the keyboard, press R to bring out the rotation as well as the scale property. Now let's rotate this texture. I'm gonna set the rotation value -90 degrees, and let's increase the size and fit the texture just like that. And then you can close the texture composition. After that you can drag and drop the texture inside of this main composition. Now we have to take one more composition, that is gonna be our media placeholder, where we can drag and drop our image or video file that we want to use in this project. So just go to the composition, take a new composition, and this is gonna be the media. Leave the setting as it is, hit OK. And now let's import any image. So just go to the project window, go to import file and select this image. You can get this image with the project file. So select the image and click on import, or you can use any image that you like. And then we have to fit the image inside of this media composition. Just go to the render composition and let's import the media inside of this main composition. After that we can animate the image, so just go to the end of this animation, hit S to bring out the scale property, click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the scale property, go to very first frame of this animation. I'm going to increase the scale value and set it 125%. We can get this type of zoom out animation as you can see. Now we have to apply one more effect on this media composition. Just go to effect and preset and search for tint. So this is the tint effect. Let's apply this tint on this media composition and make it black and white. And after that select the media composition, right click on that, click on pre-compose. Check this second option, move all attributes into the new composition and rename it properly. I'm gonna call it media animation. Hit OK. Hit T on the keyboard to bring out the opacity and set the opacity of this media animation something around 15%. And now we have something like this. After that we have to animate this texture and the media animation. So what we have to do, I'm gonna create a brush stroke kind of animation. So just deselect all the layer first, select the paint tool, click on fill and set it to none, click on stroke and set it to solid color. You can select any color, it doesn't really matter, hit OK. And set the stroke thickness something around 350 pixels. Hold control and scroll down to zoom out, and then you can create this type of shape. just like that. And now we have to arrange these point and fill this blank area. And then select the shape layer one, right click on that, click on rename, and I'm gonna call it a stroke animation. Hit enter. Perfect. And now let's animate this shape. So what we have to do, just open the stroke animation, click on the add button and add this trim path effect. Open the trim path and here we have the start and end. So let's animate the end property first. Just go to 2 seconds. Click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the end property. Just go to very first frame of this animation. Let's set the end value 0. And here we will get this type of brush stroke effect. And after that, just go to 3.5 seconds and let's animate the start property as well. So click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the start property and lock the value 0. And then just go to the end of this animation. Let's set the start value 100. So basically, we will get this type of animation in and the animation out as well. All right, after that, select all the keyframes. Hit F9 to easy ease them. You can also right click on the keyframe, go to keyframe assistant, and you can click on this easy ease option. Perfect. And now we will get this type of smooth brush stroke animation. After that, we have to apply one more effect on the stroke animation. Select the stroke animation, go to effect and preset and search for roughen edges. So this is the roughen edges effect. Let's apply this roughen edges on this stroke animation and make the edges rough. So what we have to do here, we have the border. Let's increase the border and set the value something around 30. You can play around with these parameters and you can create a unique texture kind of roughen edges. And finally, we have this type of animation. And now I'm going to use this stroke animation as a mat. So what we have to do, select the stroke animation and place it over on the texture layer. Select the texture, go to track mat. If you don't have the track mat, click on the toggle switches and change this track mat to a stroke animation. And you will get this type of texture animation as you can see. Perfect. And do the same thing with this media animation. So select the stroke animation, hit Ctrl D to create a copy. Drag the second stroke animation over on this media animation, select the media layer, go to track mat and change this to a stroke animation 2. Perfect. And as you can see, texture and the media animation both are revealing at the same time because we don't have any time gap between both the stroke animation. So let's create a time gap between both the stroke animation. Select the stroke, hit U to bring out the active keyframes for this stroke animation 2. And what we have to do is just go to 2.5 seconds and move these keyframes right over here and do the same thing with these two keyframes as well. So just go to 3 seconds, highlight these two keyframes and move it right over here. And now we have a time gap between both the stroke animations and you will get this unique effect as you can see. And after that, let's create our main text over here. So what we have to do, select the text tool, go to character. If you don't have the character, then go to window and check this option character. And after that, select your favorite font style. So in this case, I'm using this Gobold bold font style. I'm gonna set the font size something around 700 pixel. And then click over here and type first 4 letters of your text. So I want to type Nicki Minaj. We have to type N-I-C-K, the first 4 letters of the text, just like that. Hit Ctrl A to highlight all. And here we have to down the character spacing. So I'm gonna set the character spacing -100. Perfect. And then we have to align this text in the center. So just go to align, click on align horizontally and vertically and keep the text in the center. You can also click on the paragraph and click on the center text, which is very important. And now just go to project window and this is the media animation. So let's drag and drop the media animation into this main composition. Perfect. And then just select the text layer and place it over on this media animation. Select the media animation, go to track mat and change this track mat to Nick. which is the text layer. And now we have a zoom out animation as well, which is looking very cool. And after that, we have to apply one more effect on this media animation. So just go to effect and preset and search for blends. So this is the Vantian blends effect. Let's apply this Vantian blend on this media animation. And here we have the transition completion. So I'm going to set this value something around 15%. And then this is the direction. So I'm going to set the angle value 225 and make it like this. And this is the width. I'm going to set the width value 7. And here we have the feather. So either you can set the feather value 0.5 or maybe 1. And after that, you will get this type of blend effect on the image, which is looking very nice. And after that, select the media animation, select the text layer, right click on that, click on pre-compose. Check this second option and let's call it bold text. Perfect. And hit OK. After that, we have to do one more thing. Just open this bold text and select the text layer only, hold shift on the keyboard, press down arrow key 2 times or maybe 3 times and create a space for the full text over here. And now you can close the bold text as well. Go to the render composition and here we have a space for full text. So now let's create a full text. Click on the text tool, go to character. This time we have to set the size of the text maybe 70 pixel or maybe 200 pixel. 200 pixel is good. And this is the character spacing. We don't need any character spacing. So I'm going to set the character spacing 0. Click over here and type the full name or full text, whatever you want to type. Hit Ctrl A to highlight all. Just go to paragraph, click on center text, go to align and click on the align horizontally and vertically and set it in the center. You can also use any different font style for the second text. Select the singer, which is the title of the text, and let's down the size and set the value something around 130 maybe. Once again, we have to align it to the center. And then select the main text, right click on that, click on pre-compose, select the second option. I'm going to call it the main text. Let's down the size of the text. Select the move tool and place the text right over here. Just like that. You can increase the size maybe 45%. Perfect. And after that, we have to animate both the text. So what we have to do, select the bold text and the main text both. Just go to very first frame first and then just go to 15 frame. Hold Ctrl Shift D to split the layer. Then just go to 15 frame forward in time again. Hold Ctrl Shift D and split the layer and do the same thing 2 times more. Perfect. And now we have this type of 5 different layer as you can see. And then just go to 4 second and 45 frame at the end of this animation. Hold Ctrl Shift and press D to split the layer. Perfect. And then just go to very first frame. Place the CTI on the first cut. Select the layer, hit S to bring out the scale property. Let's scale it up. And now you can move the text right over here. Select this text, hit S. Let's increase the size and set this main text right over here. And then just go to the second clip. You can open the scale property for both the clips. And now you can increase the size. This time we have to place the text right over here and do the same thing with the second text. And now repeat the same thing for this one. Just go to the third clip, hit S to bring out the scale property for both the layers. You can close the first and second. Perfect. Now you can scale it up. I'm going to place this text right over here. Select this one, increase the size of the text, and I'm going to place the text right over here. And then just go to the fourth clip. You can close the third one, open the scale property of this fourth layer. I'm going to scale it up and set it like this. Now do the same thing with this one. And then you can see here, we will get this type of unique effect as you can see. Perfect. And do the same thing with the last clip. So place the CTI on the last clip. You can close all the layers and open this clip. Hit S to bring out your scale property. Perfect. Now you can scale it up just a little bit. You can set it over here. You can increase the scale and set the text right over here. So basically we have this type of unique animation as you can see. And after that we have to apply one more effect. Just go to layer, go to new and take a new adjustment layer. Right click on that, click on rename, call it color, hit enter. Just go to effect and preset and search for brightness and contrast. So this is the brightness and contrast effect. Let's apply this effect on the color layer, and this is the contrast. Let's increase the contrast. I'm gonna set the value 60. You can adjust this value according to your image or your frame, whatever you have. And now let's apply one more effect, which is the curves. So this is the curves effect. Let's apply these curves on this color adjustment layer. Just go to the blue channel and let's increase the blue saturation just a little bit and set a bluish tone for this text animation. And now we will get this type of cool looking animation as you can see. Perfect. And after that you can turn on the motion blur if you want. So click on the toggle switches, turn on the motion blur for all the layers, and then it's almost done. So just click on the full resolution, click on fit button, go to full screen, and let's have a look. Alright, it is looking pretty amazing, right? So that is the wrap for today. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial and got the value from it. If you did, then please subscribe to this channel and like this video to appreciate my hard work. And also, do comment below this video if you have any questions or thoughts. My name is Vikash and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.